This time I would like to call on the Continental Coordinator of the Movement for African National Initiative, the Reverend Ruben Esemandu. And our dear brother here will be praying for Nepal and also would lead us in praying for the Philippines.
Please can we close our eyes and pray. Father, we want to thank you for the great things we have had. And it's a privilege, oh God, to know that in these days of so many uncertainties, shakings and rumblings and tumblings that are going on in this world, that you are at work. We give you glory for this in the name of Jesus. Jesus, you also promised that you will build your church and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And we have heard these testimonies, O God, from Nepal and from the Philippines. We thank you, Lord, for the light that is shining in the dark places of Nepal. We thank you, Lord, for the overrunning of the kingdom of darkness by your kingdom of light. We thank you for the open doors, O God, and the great opportunities you are giving to your church to increase there. We still recognize, O God, the fact there are so many contentions against your plan, your purposes for the people of Nepal. And we want to invoke your promise that said, O Lord, that the knowledge of the glory of the Lord will cover the whole earth as water covers the sea. And we speak that to Nepal. And we say, Lord, your light will shine in the dark places, and the darkness cannot comprehend it in Nepal in the name of Jesus. We speak to you, the gates, lift up your heads, the political gates, the religious gates, all the social gates, every mountain that is rising up against the knowledge of God in Nepal, we speak unto you today as the church of Jesus gathered in this place. We speak unto you that you will lift up your head so that the gospel will have a free course in the country of Nepal in the name of Jesus. Father, we also pray that you will strengthen your church, even though, Lord, it appears to be small at this time. But as the living seed, the church in Nepal will grow. We ask, O God, that you will pour out your spirit upon your people, your servants there. The Lord, from being the minority, they will also become the majority. The Lord, your light will shine so brightly through the witnessing of your people. Strengthen them in these days, O God, of your power, so that they will move on with boldness, preaching the gospel, even to those places that are already hidden from the gospel. We thank you also, Lord, for what you are doing with the Filipino church. We bless you, O God, for your good hand that is upon this country. The way, O God, that your seeds of righteousness have been scattered from here to many countries, especially in those places, O God, that are hitherto closed to conventional evangelism. Lord, you have been planting your seed of righteousness through the people, your people you have sent to these places. We give you glory for this. And we pray, Lord, that in these days of your power, when there are more shakings, oh God, that you're using to create access of the gospel to the people who have not had it before, that you will use the Filipino church the more. We ask, everlasting Father, that you will release upon the leaders, O God, the wisdom to know how to manage, how to organize, how to coordinate, O God, this great opportunity you are giving to them, O Lord. The access you have granted to the church in Philippines, O God, to these places, O God, that are close to conventional missions. We pray, Lord, for the plans they have put together to multiply the church in this country, to have more entrance and access to those unreached people groups, oh God, especially the Muslim ones. We pray, Lord, that you set up the hearts of your people in this land, that they will recognize this great opportunity and make use of it. We also pray, oh God, for the scattered seeds of the church in the countries of this world, especially in the Middle East and Arab countries. Father, we thank you for what you're already using them to do. May you increase, O God, their effectiveness in witnessing for you, not only through their words, but through their lives. Father, Lord, that the knowledge of your glory, O God, will permeate the dark places of these areas where we have sent them, and they will shine brighter and brighter in the name of Jesus. Lord, we speak also concerning your promise in these end times. Jesus, it's true, O God, that there are a lot of things that are contending for your glory. But we recognize the fact that you said, O God, that of the increase of your kingdom, there shall be no end. In spite of all those powers that are contending for your glory, we ask, Lord Jesus, that you will rule from the north to the south, from the east to the west. Let, O God, the power of the Holy Spirit rise up, O God, and let your church rise in strength. That in these days, O God, where the forces of darkness are trying, O God, to oppose the spread of the gospel, that you raise up, O God, your church with might and strength to penetrate and to push forward even through the frontiers that you are creating for us. We thank you, Lord, for what you are doing, using political situations, economic situations, using even the natural phenomena to create access for the spread of the gospel. I pray that you stir up the eyes of your church in this region, in this continent, to see the opportunities that these things are providing for us, so that we will rise up and take advantage of them, including, oh Lord, the Macedonian calls that are coming from Europe and America, from where we received the gospel. And now that you are sending the harvest field to those places, we pray, Lord, that our eyes will be opened and we take advantage of it in these days of your power. We have asked for all these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.